Breeze surveys, throws, Cook delivers a blow, fights for a first down, knocked down near the 26-yard line after a catch and push of 14 yards.
So you're gonna try to clock this. They got more in mind than just tying this thing up.
And now we're going to get a flag. We'll see who this is against. Remember, a running clock, if it's against the Saints, there'd be a 10-second runoff, or they can use their timeout. Mike?
Yeah, listen, even if they're not set and it's inside of 2 minutes with the clock running, then it converts to a false start and does create that 10-second runoff, which, of course, New Orleans could use that last time.
Offense, all players did not get set prior to the ball being snapped. Inside 2 minutes, that shift turned into a false start that involves a 5-yard penalty and a 10-second runoff. Please set the game clock to 21 seconds. The clock will start on my signal.
So they're going to take 10 seconds off the clock. And you see that lunge there by Kamara down at the bottom. But the Saints could use their timeout.
They could, and he misspoke. You're going to run it down to 11 from the 21.
And now they're going to make sure, this officiating crew, again, a mixed crew. These are not guys that work together all season long.
10-second runoff involved in this penalty. Thank you. The clock will start on my signal.
Key is, Joe, the clock's going to start on the ready for play. So as soon as Carl Cheffers chops his hand and gives the wind signal, the clock's going to start. And that's what he's telling Breeze right now. You need to be aware that when I blow the whistle, the clock is going to start.
And again, they could use their timeout and avoid the 10-second run.
But I like that they kept the timeout. It just keeps a lot more an option for them.
And this play's not there for Kamara now. 7 seconds remain.
You do have Drew Breeze, and I understand it. If you use the timeout, you got to really trust your quarterback, as you would Drew Brees, in handling that, and then what you're able to do, because now you're talking about a run on the field goal attempt to tie this thing up. And you know, there wasn't anything there. They thought maybe they could get in a little bit closer and who knows, spring one, but they keep the timeout, which gave them some more options within the play call. They, as it turns out, they didn't do anything with it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's something to debate. Meanwhile, it'll be a 49-yard try here. And Mike Zimmer is going to use a timeout. That kick does not count. You can read the lips. Zimmer saying, I called it 20 seconds ago, and they're letting him kick it anyway. And Lutz wants that ball back that he just put through the uprights. It didn't count. I don't know. I guess you and I just disagree. I would have avoided the 10-second runoff. Believe that they could get more yardage, go to the sideline even without the timeout. They're going to end the game, it looks like, with a timeout in their pocket. Here's a 49-yard drive, and this one is good. And a tie ball game with 2 seconds left. Pass is caught for the first down. That's Diggs. Play action. Cousins. Thielen. He's got it. Inside the 5. The ball sitting at the 2. 43 yards from Kirk Cousins to Adam Thielen, and they're 2 yards away from a win.
Adam Thielen against Patrick Robinson, and Kirk Cousins, he sees it immediately. He's got the one-on-one look. It's the best throw of his career right here with what's on the line. And for him to be able to drop that right out of the sky, Thielen gets a couple steps, and he delivers it on the money.
Toss to Cook. Play gets strung out. Cook stopped back near the 5.
Yeah, Rudolph up here at the top.
Cousins throws. Pass is caught for the win. Kyle Rudolph and the Vikings. Vikings are moving on. Absolute stunned silence here in New Orleans. The Saints wondering if there's going to be a review for a push-off. And how ironic would that be if they give that a look?
Well, he definitely extends the right arm, but from what we've seen throughout the year, you can't imagine that would be overturned. But Mike, I'm going to defer to you.
Thanks. I'll give it back to you, Troy. This is one now that New York will look at. They have to make a decision. They have to make a decision on whether or not, A, there is pass interference, and is it big enough in the replay situation they have with pass interference now to call. Clearly, he does get separation, and he does extend the arm.
And they are not going to look at it. And this is a final, 26-20. Let's go down to Chris Myers.